So today is an interactive what? Class. And we'll be talking about what? Our parents. But first of all, I want to ask you all a question. What is the best legacy a father can leave for his family in this country? Yes, Esther.
The best legacy a father can leave for his family is a good name.
Good. Put your hands together for Esther. The best legacy a father can leave for his family in this country is what? Good name. Because even the Bible said that a good name is better than what? Silver and gold. Success.
Yes.
Stand up. What are you doing?
I'm trying to copy the notice I should copy.
Must you do that now? Not that I'm talking. Ngwa, come outside. I'm teaching you're doing something else. Dosi Shidika Wangwere. Bia, are you not part of this class?
Auntie, I'm part of this class now.
Okay, what was the last thing I said?
Okay, Auntie, you said what is the best legacy a father can leave for his family in this country? Then Esther now said the best legacy a father can leave for his family in this country is a good name.
Okay, that's
good. I want to ask you a small question.
Go on.
Which country are we talking about here?
Are we not in Nigeria?
We're in Nigeria.
We're talking about Nigeria now.
And you said the best legacy a father can leave for his family in this Nigeria is a good name.
Yes, of course.
Only?
Yes, it's even in the Bible.
Auntie, see, the best legacy a father can leave for his family in this country, in this Nigeria, is money. Plenty of money. And dual citizenship. In case they sell this country tomorrow.
Yay.
So that we know where to run to. I feel like be serious in this class. Wahala for this country, they like temporal. No, no degree end. Who good name help Kwame?
Come on, go and sit down. Change. You are lucky this is a holiday lesson. I would have flogged you here now. All of you should shut up, John. Oh yeah, close that book and put it inside your locker. Wait. In fact, we are going to something else. If I punch you, you stand up and tell me something nice about your father. Do you all understand?
Yes, Auntie.
Ngwa, Abigail, stand up.
My father is so nice. He takes us to Dubai every Christmas.
Wow,
that's nice. Put your hands together for her. Yes, Esther.
My father is so nice. He calls me a queen and calls my brother a king.
Oh. Wow, put your hands together for her. Yes, Mirabel.
My father is so nice. Every time my mom asks him for transport, he buys her a car.
Wow, can you imagine that? Please clap for her. This is someone's husband though. Godwin. Yes, gospel.
My father is so nice. He dug 5 swimming pools in our compound for me and my 4 siblings. Ha.
Wow, 5 swimming pools, cha. Put your hands together for gospel. That means the whole compound can not ban me. Please, somebody should not drown, no. Yes, you.
My father is so nice. I asked him for a pet and he bought me a dragon.
Hey!
Jesus Christ.
Success! What is it?
Auntie's nothing.
So what did you shout? Oh yeah, stand up. Tell us something nice about your father.
Okay. My father is so nice. I told him that I have headache and he bought me a new head.
Success! What kind of lie is that?
It's not like competition we are doing this class. I just enjoying this class before Mirabel now started. The big hair gospel. Me. Gospel, why didn't you tell us your family is full of married spirits? Then you. Your father bought you dragon. Melin. Kai. Nothing protesters no go see for like 2 gates. You know the dragon. You should have told us that your father is the king in Game of Thrones.
Auntie, so this is what we are doing now. Line competition. I beg, I'm not doing it again. This is a new year job. All of you, I'm your madras. Lie on me. Or just end me. I'm your sass. You should do fast, you. Before turn bread to sand and judgment to meet you people inside here.
What is it now?
Come, oh. Come and see your daughter. Oh. Look at Success.
Success! What are you doing here? Are you not supposed to be in school?
Mm-hmm. Daddy, I don't want to go to school. I've resigned.
You are not supposed to resign from school, young lady. It's not a job.
Okay, I've retired.
Aya, get up from there. Go inside. Go and dress up. Your mates are in school and you want to stop school when you don't know the difference between resign and retire.
What is happening here?
Kebran, see you. Success says she doesn't want to go to school again.
Success says she doesn't want to go to school again.
You can imagine.
Hey, start business for her now.
Kebran, we are being very serious here. Very, very serious, please.
Okay. Success, what really happened?
Okay, say anything that I read this and I go to school, they'll mark me bad. I'm telling you, I cannot go to that school again.
Who does that? Where?
See, actually, this thing has been happening since. Over this while that you traveled, I have suffered. There's one that happened one day.
Prefer. My best desire teacher gave me an assignment, and I got it right. But she failed me and still flogged me.
Ha! Again?
Yes. That's not all, though. There's one other day, too. Wait. You mean school just resumed and people have not taught them anything and you gave her tests? Who does that? Don't even pay me the most, eh? It's one that even have to carry Emanuela and Mark to that school. See, I've said this thing before. I don't like coming here. I don't know why all the time you will keep making success to bring us from the compound to this people's office. Why did I bring you to your office, eh? You know, can't go here. You ain't call rice. See, me, I'm tired. I don't even want to go to that school again. I'm tired.
Are you serious?
Yes.
Oh yeah, go inside and wear uniform. Go. Let's go and see that person that will mark you bad when you got your assignment right.
Again? Eh? Auntie, again? What is wrong with you teachers in this school? Eh? How can a child get something correctly yet you mark the child bad? Always making her parents and guardians go to my office all the time.
Principal, no, the answer she gave me was wrong. That's why I failed her.
Hey! Auntie, you're lying on my head in my presence.
Principal, I have heard this is not the first time.
Yes.
Not even the second time.
I don't know.
Sir, Principal, stop disguising. It's like this is a tradition in this school for both of you.
No, sir.
Sir, just calm down.
Don't tell me to calm down. Which one is calm down? Don't tell me to calm down. Just imagine.
Dear principal, if you people are not going to teach this girl, tell us, let us remove her.
No, ma. It has no good into that.
I can't believe that I'm still here.
In fact, please, just give me a minute. Let me sort this out, please. Auntie, tell me, what really happened?
Principal, last week Friday, I gave them a quiz. Today, I'll be giving you a quiz. I just have 2 questions. You have 3 minutes to answer them. Once it's 3 minutes, I'm coming to take your answer sheet. Whether you're finished or not. Is that clear?
Yes.
Now, listen. I don't want to squeeze your answer sheet. And I don't want any cancellation. If not, there's no mark for you. Pass it to the back. Think before you write. If you like, write nonsense. I'm going to see you that answer sheet. Mila, are you in this class? Okay. Number 1. What is your favorite food? Think before you write. Remember, no cancellation. make sure you write what I can see, oh. Yes, success.
Auntie, my pen is not writing.
Success, you mean you bought a pen that is not writing to my class? Okay. I'll give you another one. But I'm not waiting for you. My 3 minutes is my 3 minutes. Number two. Briefly explain how to prepare your favorite food. Why are you looking at me? Don't you have a favorite food? Right, tell your favorite food. Explain how to prepare it. Remember, no cancellation. And principal, what she wrote didn't make sense at all.
Success. Tell me, what was your answer?
Hot water.
Success. Hot water. Success. Water kwa.
Water is also one of the 6 classes of food.
Success. Water is part of the 6 classes of food, no doubt. But not hot water.
When you cook water, it will become hot now. That's why I said hot water. Anna.
Success. When did you start eating hot water as your favorite food?
I wonder.
Mommy, there's no difference between the soup you should prepare and hot water.
Hey. Madam, do you cook hot water? Principal, this is not why we are here.
I'm neighbor. Busy body.
Principal, better tell this auntie to give my correct mark. You know, I'll change this school and enter another school. Then I'm going home.
You see? This is how it always ends. He will fire her. In the next episode, he will bring her back. I brought myself here. I'll take myself out.
Sir. Please, calm down. I can explain. Actually, you are fired. ma, you see, we also offer classes in this school.
What kind of rubbish is that? I'll kill this man. I'll kill this man. What kind of rubbish is that? Are you mad? I'm going on my bed. He doesn't even know me.
Why are you doing like this now, eh? Calm down. How much? Mess up. Mess up.
Auntie, it's past 2 and everybody has gone home, mainly only our class.
So you want to go home and leave only me here, eh? You want to go home and leave only me here? Can't you see the work I'm doing here?
But auntie, you're not doing anything now.
Okay, people want to go home, Abby?
Yes!
I'll ask you a question and anybody that answers it correctly can go home. Do you all agree?
Yes!
Chibika, you have 15 oranges. And you gave 5 to Precious. How many will be remaining?
15.
How?
I am not going to give Fair Precious my oranges, so. Because if she has her own, she will not give me.
Shut up your mouth and sit down there.
Auntie. The answer is 10.
Good. Correct answer. Go and carry your bag and go home.
Auntie, thank you. God bless you.
You're welcome.
Auntie, ask another one.
Okay. What is 104 and 66?
Auntie.
Success.
CNN and Cartoon Network in our TV remote.
Look at her head. Come on, sit down there. You look like Cartoon Network.
Auntie, I.
Yes, Chibike.
104 and 66 is 170.
Good. Correct answer. Go and carry your bag and go home.
Yes.
Okay, auntie, ask another one.
Okay. There are 5 birds on the tree. If a hunter shoots 2,
How many will remain?
Auntie.
Or your sources?
No man will remain.
Sit down there.
Olodo.
Auntie.
Yes, precious.
If 5 birds are on a tree and a hawk that shoots 2, 3 will remain.
Good, correct answer. Precious, go and carry your bag and go home. Let all these dumb ones remain here.
But auntie.
Yes, sources.
If there are 5 birds on a tree and a hunter shoots even one, the rest will fly away now.
Sources. No, it's 3 that will be remaining. But I like the way you think. Sit down. But that doesn't mean you're not dumb, Sha.
Auntie,
mm?
Can I ask you a question?
Mm-hmm.
But if I ask you this question and you fail it, I'll go home. Oh.
What kind of question can you possibly ask me that I cannot answer?
Auntie, if I ask you this question and you fail it, I'll go home. Oh. Are you doing or not?
Success, ask your question.
Okay, there are 5 ladies. And 4 of them are wearing trousers and shirts. But 1 is wearing gown. Which one is married?
The one putting on the gown, of course.
Auntie, no. It's the one that is wearing wedding ring that is married. But I like the way you think. But that doesn't mean you're not dumb, Sha. I'm going home. See you on Monday. If I don't go and marry, you think this class doesn't know that you are 25 and you are still doing boyfriend and girlfriend? Ha 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 ha!